Hey guys, it's Miss Deacon here. I thought I would record this Zoom session to show anyone else who's still sleeping or just can't make it at this time, you know, what we do on Zoom and some drawing tutorials. So anyways, I have two cameras. I have my laptop looking at me and looking at the board, and I have my iPad here looking at what it is I'm going to be drawing. So this week the topic is color. In previous weeks, we discussed line, shape, value, form, and now we're on color. This is like the building blocks of art. You know, every different element that you learn contributes to your art making and the success of what it is that you're trying to create. So the first element is line, right? Just a simple lines, curvy, straight, short, dotted, tight, curly, angular, and zigzag. All of these are lines, and that is the basic foundation of creating art. As soon as you make a mark, you are creating art, right? It's an imprint of your expression. So the second element is shape. So when you connect lines together, start to create shapes, and when you do this, that starts to provide more information about what it is that you're attempting to draw or attempting to recreate on a two-dimensional surface. Something that's really important when you're drawing from life is your line weight, and that means how thick or thin a line is, and that may require different kinds of tools. For example, you can try to get a really thin line. It's kind of harder to do with the marker. So you can always gather the lines together and make a really thick line or a really thin line. This is important because when you're drawing from life in person, there's actual physical space involved. So the parts of the object that are closer to you are going to be more bold and thick because it's closer to your eye. The things that are farther off in the distance you're gonna render them with thinner lines because there's actual physical air and light and space in between the viewer's eye and the object. So I'll try to demonstrate that a little bit when I get into the drawing tutorial. So actually now is just a good time to start drawing my subject, and I'll explain this as I go along. So the subject that I picked is this teapot. I love this teapot. It's got some interesting colors on it. That's why I picked it for today. You can always start by drawing anything in black and white. That's the best place to start because that's the best place that you're gonna really get a handle of line and shape and value and start to get into form. So let me continue to explain while I start to draw this teapot. So if you've come to the Zoom sessions before, you know that I like to do some contour line drawings just to warm up from. So I'm going to do a few practice because I haven't actually drawn today yet. So I'm going to look at my object, and I'm not even going to look at my paper. I'm just going to trace what it is that I'm seeing and pretend like what it is that I'm drawing is actually matching up. So, okay. There we go. We got the teapot. Obviously, it looks super funky because I was not looking at my paper as I was drawing back and forth. But that's not the point. The point is just to warm up and start to wake up your eyes and your hands and literally your hand-eye coordination. Just like sports, it's the same thing in art. So I'm gonna do that again, but now maybe I'll like look back at my paper a little bit to see if what I'm drawing is accurate. This part around the handle is a little confusing, so I'm gonna skip that for a second. So it's a balance between, you know, trusting that you're drawing what your eye is seeing, and I always have trouble getting it on the paper and getting it exactly how it appears in person. Now, what is difficult about this teapot is this handle has a lot of detail because it's kind of this like wooden situation. So, you know, you can always go back and correct a drawing, but the more accurate you kind of start those guidelines off with, the easier that your drawing is going to be as you progress into it with the color and the value. So, okay, I don't know why it's sideways. That, you know, that's my second teapot. So first teapot, a little funky. Second teapot, looking a little bit better. So I'm gonna move into possibly a more formal drawing of this, just because I don't want this video to be like forever. So I'm gonna draw this teapot again, and this time I'm gonna grab a different pencil. I'm gonna explain a little bit more how I am drawing the line and turning into the shape, which turns into the value, which turns into the form or the three-dimensional object, and then how we add color on top of that. I actually did that last week, just because drawing in black and white was getting a little boring. So, okay, I have a normal pencil because I don't like mechanical pencils. I think that the edge on the lead is too angular and it like digs into your paper. And the thing with paper is, you know, yeah, you can draw on paper and erase it, but the paper has memory. So you will have an indentation on your paper, especially depending on how hard you're pressing with the pencil. So I always recommend to kind of start light and then gradually increase the darkness, which kind of moves us into value. So, okay. Something important to also look at is, where is your light source coming from? My light source is coming from this lamp, but perhaps two lights is too much. So I'm going to turn it down and just have one light so that it's a little bit more intense on the object so that I can really see the shadows and what it is that I'm drawing. So, all right, same, make any last adjustments before you start drawing something. I'm going to try to make this as simple as possible and get kind of like a head-on view. Cats are fighting. Alright, so I'm going to start with, I think a good place for me to start with is this lid. Like I said, I kind of have issues getting the whole thing on the paper. So I'm just going to start with some rough guideline drawings, and it's okay to make them look scribbly. The idea is that you're getting all of these different lines on here, and then choosing the one that's most accurate to the placement of your object. So this part is really complicated because it's kind of like a loop that the wooden handle goes through, but I'm going to try my best here. Okay, as I'm drawing this out, I see that I'm going to run off of the paper. That is one of my issues, so I'm just going to call it another study, and maybe this time I will turn my paper this way so that I can get the whole object on. Some people draw really big, some people draw really tiny. I'm more of like a big drawer, but all right. So if I want the whole thing to fit on here, I know that this handle is gonna have to come here somewhere. This is kind of lid of the teapot. This is the side of the teapot. This is the bottom. This is the spout, and the spout kind of comes out this direction. So, okay, looks like I'm going to be able to fit it, so let's work with that. All right, since I have some guidelines down, I'm going to go back in and kind of draw things more accurately. I seem to be starting with the second part of this lid. So I'm going to draw them a little darker. And guys, really, drawing is so much practice. You know, the more that you draw, the more that you're gonna look at the relationships that are happening in the object that you're drawing, and that's what is gonna lead to drawing things more accurately. I've always been more of a cartoon drawer, so to draw from real life, I'm not a photorealistic drawer. It definitely challenges me too. So let's see, as a scene here, I'm part, it kind of comes up a little bit. Again, I'm looking a lot at my object, because when you look at the object that you're drawing, you are getting direct information. If you look away from the object, now you're drawing from memory or what you think the object looks like. Again, with this kind of weird mechanism to hold the wooden handle. Maybe even draw it on the side, because it's kind of like a weird thing to think about. And erasing is totally fine. I usually like don't erase, but that's just me. I think there's a lot of, so I'm giving the teapot an overall look here. I'm looking at kind of this little indentation that's in between the handle and the top of this lid. See that it pops out a little bit more. This side is also closer, so I'm gonna widen that a little bit, no shame. A little dip. Holder comes down this way. Kind of has a little bump here for the spout. Okay, so I've drawn a lot of lines and I have connected them in certain places. So that means I've created shapes. So I've been creating a shape of this teapot anytime a line touches another line. Kind of looks like the teapot from Beauty and the Beast. But all right, let's see about this kind of wooden thing, this wooden handle. It's okay to draw something that like you don't quite understand, you know, or that doesn't make sense to your eye. As an artist, it's your decision whether or not you're gonna include parts of your object in with your actual drawing. I could certainly omit this whole wooden handle thing, but I feel like it gives the drawing some balance, so I'm gonna keep it. So now I'm looking at the thickness of this wooden handle. And I see that the wooden handle has two parts. It has the main part, and then it has kind of like this extra wraparound thing that's happening. So I'm gonna draw the wraparound thing in a minute to get the thickness of this kind of set up. So, okay, I have kind of like a, I have a rough contour drawing of the teapot. It's not a blind contour because I was looking back and forth between the object and my paper. What I was doing before, just looking at the teapot and not looking at my paper, that's a blind contour, and that's more of a warm up your, you know, hand-eye coordination. So I have some lines here that have turned into shapes because I've connected them. So the next thing to investigate is value. And the way that I'm gonna add the value and form to this teapot is by using pencil, then I'm going to go back and add some color on top of it. Lately, what I've been doing, this is just my art style, but I've been drawing in pencil, and then I go back with like a thin black marker and kind of emphasize certain lines that I've drawn with some shading with the marker, and then I go back and I add some color on top of that. That's just my art style. You can start with color, you can just do pencil, you know, it just depends on what kind of materials you have and what you have to work with. So I'm gonna make any more adjustments here. I see from my angle that the top of the teapot spout is not quite so dipped. It's a little bit more, thick. So I'm looking at all these places of connection, like where the different parts of the teapot are meeting the other parts. This is all in the end gonna help it make it look more three-dimensional, even if as you're drawing it you're like, I don't know, man, this is like looking real weird. So get that, and then this pretty curvy on the side. Again, look how many lines I have drawn. That's okay. Like when you feel confident about the line that's most accurate, that's when you're gonna go back and you're gonna emphasize that line, kind of like how I'm doing now. Like I'm just making the parts that I think are the line that's most accurate, I'm making that one darker. So I have the top of this lid here, and it kind of seems to go out wider, so I'm gonna pop that out the best that I can. It also has this hole here that's for the steam, and you have, this is a functional teapot. When I'm talking, it's because I'm concentrating, and when I'm drawing, it is harder to talk and drop at the same time. Okay, so I'm satisfied with that lid. I'm gonna turn it this way so you guys can see. You know, when I look at it in person, it looks a little bit more wider at the top of where the lid is. But I'm gonna maybe erase these lines and see if that helps it look a little bit wider. I have a lot of distraction with the lines going on. So, okay, that actually looks better. It actually kind of looks like the lid is sitting inside, you know, the teapot a little bit. There's some things that aren't maybe 100% correct here, but that's okay, because even I am still practicing as your art teacher. So, okay, I have line, I have shape. I'm gonna start to add some value, and this is what's really gonna make it look kind of look three-dimensional when I start doing this. So there's a darker line here, and the confusing thing about value is that color all has a value, right? A darker color is gonna have a darker value, like this, you know, darker blue may appear darker. So this is what's confusing to someone, you know? What I can do is I can take a picture of the teapot. I can change it to black and white, and that's gonna help me a lot with seeing where the values are without confusing the blue of the teapot with the real value of it. So, okay, I just took a picture of it on my phone. I turned it to black and white. Maybe I'll include this picture when I post this video. Anyway, so I have my teapot now, and basically what I was doing, it was accurate. There is a dark shadow here because the way the teapot is shaped, it comes in and then it goes out. Another thing that you can do if you don't want to take a picture, you don't have something to take a picture with, is you can just squint your eyes at your object and you're going to see where the shadows are. So this is kind of like so I'm just kind of scribbling in like the darker areas of the shadow. Now there's a few things going on here. Like I said, you have the value, but then I also have the pattern of like the blue on this teapot. So I'm gonna just draw the pattern of where I see the lines for the blue in. Then I'm gonna go back and start to shade my teapot. By shading, I'm just gonna color it in where I see those colors happening. So I see that there's a dark shadow here bouncing off of the light, and then another dark shadow here, which you can kind of anticipate because the light is coming from the right side of the object. So all the shadows are gonna be on the darker side of the object. This is also kind of a hard object to draw because there's a lot of reflection going on in the object. I'm gonna squint my eyes and just kind of see what it's reflecting that's dark, because that is contributing to the darker value on the front of the teapot. And to some degree, guys, you're just kind of completing it. You know, you're just filling it in. I see that it has a highlight right here, so I'm gonna add some color around that spot. So I'm doing two things right now. I am including the darker values that I'm seeing on the teapot, but I'm also preliminarily shading in this section of the teapot, which is like a teal color, kind of a light color, because these bottom two sections are a darker, it's actually painted a darker blue. So that's, you know, it's value in two different ways. It's values with the lights of the light that's hitting the teapot, and then it's the values of the blues, which contribute to the color that we see. And something else to remember is directional lines. You know, this teapot is curved and the blue seems to be kind of dripping. So I'm gonna have my lines drop going downwards to show that it's curving. And it's got a really darker band of blue here. So I'm gonna color that darker band of blue. I'm kind of combining the two things. I'm combining the color of the teapot that I see along with the shadow. So there's like a lot going on to look at here. I totally understand why people find drawing hard. I still find drawing pretty challenging for me, especially when you're trying to do something that, you know, isn't really your natural style. All right, this section of the teapot is light blue, so I'm gonna do a really light shade of gray here, because what's happening on the teapot is it's bouncing the white of the table, reflecting in the teapot, so I'm seeing a lighter shade here, but I'm gonna reflect that just to give the teapot some differentiation. There's a lot of reflection going on here, so I'm just gonna. Now the reflection that I'm seeing on the spout, it does carry that color over, like the dark blue band that's here, it kind of travels up this way, and then it's got the teal, but it's also got a lot of reflections going on. So I'm gonna mimic that with, you know, some kind of more chaotic, like different types of values in the pencil and line stroke. All right, this is the part that let me do the lid first. The edge of the lid is darker, so I'm gonna draw that, but also it's got some highlights. So again, sometimes it's best to just kind of squint your eye and color like where you see it being the darkest. You know, will you come up with the most accurate drawing? Maybe not, but that's not really, you know, the point is just practice and to get better and be proud about what you do, and just, it doesn't matter that it's super accurate or not. I recommend starting when you're doing this maybe with like a white cup or a mug or something that's one color. If you haven't practiced doing this with objects yet, I would recommend starting with a white object, because that's going to give you the easiest values to look at and give you the less, you know, distractions in your object to draw. So, okay, it seems like there's a lot of things wrapping around here. This is where my abstract drawing style is gonna really show up, because it looks like it has this kind of like wooden wrap around it. Am I counting exactly how many I'm doing? No, I am just trying to look at the shapes and the diagonal, you know, direction of these bands, and then when I get a little distracted, like now it comes out like too thick. So I'm just trying to get the essence of the object. I'm not Janet Fish, which is someone who draws like extremely photorealistic. I'm not Chuck Close. That's someone who also like paints like they're painting photographs, but they're not. The thing that's really bothering me is the lid inside the spout here has a dark shadow. And right, your eye's gonna bounce around. Like it's gonna pick up on things that are not accurate. So if you keep going back to one section, you have to ask yourself, what about this is so inaccurate that I keep like honing in on it? All right, that was I did a lot of lines. I did a lot of shapes. I tried to make some kind of value here. Maybe what I need is actually, it's also not just the object that you're drawing, but it's what's around the object. So I have my object on kind of this pedestal with like a napkin over it. So I don't have a lot of room to show that, but what I do have room to show is this shadow that is popping out because I put the light on it. So I'm gonna try to draw some shadows. It's starting to kind of blend in with the actual teapot, but you know, I'm gonna go back in with this thin black marker, and I'm gonna firm some stuff up. So this is gonna kind of get really drastic pretty quickly, because marker is, I mean, depending on obviously what color you use, marker is very dark and you can't erase it, so you know, it's good to practice with pencil, and if you like pencil, then just continue with the pencil. I'm not really a pencil person. I'm more of like a bold marker painting type of person. So I'm gonna go in and add some value with this marker, but I'm not going to abandon looking at my object. I'm going to still reference my object, even though it looks like I have a lot of information on this paper with all of the marks I've made so far. Always continue to look at your object. That is what is going to be the most accurate thing for you to look at. So I'm going to start. And again, it's harder to control your line weight with the marker, but what you want to do is you want to look at the edge of the picture drawing. Look at how it creates a shape against the background compared to the object that you're doing now. So I see that the edge of the top of this actually comes out pretty high, not quite that high, but it sticks out to show that the lid is kind of inset into this teapot. So I am gonna, again, looking at this negative space of how the edge of the mouth of the teapot kind of connects to the body of it. It's all about the details, you know, if you get a really minute detail correct, it's gonna really make the rest of your drawing look more accurate. And your eye is not gonna have an issue with what it's looking at, because what it's looking at is something. So this has a really wide kind of, hook to attach the wooden handle with. I'm gonna leave this for now. Again, I'm looking at the shape that this object is creating against the background. To some degree, yes, I am tracing the lines that I already did, because I feel like I tried to do what was a pretty informed drawing on the teapot to begin with, I see that there's a seam there on the teapot, bottom of it, darker. All right, I know that I'll have an issue right here with this problem. It looks a little, I haven't drawn the inside of the spout. There's a lot of reflection going on here with kind of the inside of the spout and how it tapers. I got kind of a decent outline going on there. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna block out where these color lines are, so that when I go back and I add the color, I have some kind of reference. I hopefully I don't color over all of my rough values. So this is kind of this dark blue band. This is really interesting. Now I'm going to start to kind of block in some value. So with the marker, when you're adding value, the closer that your lines are together, obviously the darker the value that you're going to create. The farther apart that you put your lines, you're indicating that it has less shadow and it's more light in value. There's a fine line here with the marker, because like I said, it's permanent and you can't erase it or lighten it unless you have a gray marker or something. As I look at this, I see that I drew too low, so that's okay. I'm gonna look back at the shape. I'm going to not talk for a minute. Add the value with of doing is any place that has that light turquoise by itself, I'm kind of leaving that the white of the paper, and I'm seeing what other shadows I can really create. The darks and the lights are super important. It's the middle tones that trips everyone up, and starts to blend everything together. So definitely look out for that. And another rule of thumb with value and starting to shade in is that you can always make it darker, at least with marker, but you can't erase that marker. So it's the same thing with pencil though. You start, start light and then you can always increase the darkness. All try to keep in mind the shape of the teapot here and draw directional lines to help inform what it is. So here has a really darker shadow. So all around the edge here, because it's casting shadows on itself because it's such a complicated type of object. So here I want it really dark. So I'm gonna dark, 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 dark. And then as it tapers out here, it does have some kind of shadow around this highlight. So I'm just gonna, add some lines, and it's okay that you even, line direction is also really important to inform the object, that you're drawing. So I'm kind of bouncing around here. I find that works better for me, but some people really, they work more in sections of the drawing, or like they just work on this corner and then they move out from there. Now I'm getting to a point where I don't want to add too much more marker, at least black marker, because I don't want to start to dull this out or make it look like, just confusing. So let's look at it this way. Okay, so yeah, I'm having an issue with like the lid and the spout and maybe like the handles on the side, but whatever. I'm gonna add some color and just kind of see if that beefs it up. The last thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna look at this wooden handle thing, and I'm gonna try my best to kind of get some kind of texture, which is actually our next lesson, I think, is texture. I haven't really talked about it yet, but I'm gonna try to just get this to read as like a wooden, like a wooden handle. So I'm gonna draw the outline of the wooden handle like I had originally done. And it's got a bunch of lines here, but then as it gets more out, the spiral gets more spread out. And look at each individual spiral. Each one has really its own personality. You can break it down to kind of like little diagonal rectangles. Some of them kind of stick, actually all of them kind of come above because it's wrapping around the wooden handle. So you actually, when you're drawing, think about like the mechanics of what it is that you're drawing and how, it functions, and that it will help you to draw something that looks believable, looks like that object is supposed to do that, and that's the amazing thing about art, is that you can draw things without them really existing. So overall, I would have to say maybe the mouth of this teapot is a little bit narrow, and now I just completely drew over all of that that really good negative space I had in between these wooden handles and the edge of the teapot. I can see it much more clearly in front of me than I know that you guys can looking at this video and also looking at my drawing. So, okay, I'm semi-satisfied with that. I'm going to leave, almost satisfied. I'm gonna leave the pencil here. I'm not gonna erase it, but if you wanna erase it, that's up to you, I'm gonna leave it because I feel like it helps me to create some type of value on it. So again, I'm more of a marker person, so I might be using my markers here, but colored pencils are great, crayons are great. You may wanna do the whole thing in marker and never even use pencil, but that's on you. Let's see what colors I have. Interesting, turquoise marker that's shiny. I have a gray marker that might come in handy. Light blue Sharpie. Green, why not? I don't know about that. Turquoise Sharpie, that's better. And what's this marker, but I don't know if it works. And highlighter green, maybe not for this one. Okay, another blue Sharpie. I guess that's what I needed, was all the blue Sharpies. So that's my color choice. this. So that's a pretty wide, you know, array of blues and turquoises, and I definitely have this brown that I use for the wooden handle. I also have this tan, and I don't know, I have this gold marker that might be kind of interesting. So, okay. That's what I'm working with, color palette-wise. And now, it is kind of like paint like number, but, you know, you want to still, you don't just want to go for it. You do want to, like, have some thought about what it is that you're doing. And I'm not even going to color it in completely. I'm going to continue with this this line-making business, which is called patching, if you're going in all the same direction. Or cross-hatching if, you know, you start to crisscross the lines, and that will make it darker. So, you know, depending on how far apart or how close together you put your lines, hatching or cross-hatching, it's going to increase the darkness in value of what you're doing in details. Okay, so I'm going to start with kind of this top part. Remember, I'm thinking about how this teapot is functioning. This teapot is coming out, you know, this way towards me. So I want to do the same thing with my lines. Hopefully that will inform the viewer of the art that now when I get here, it does get a little bit lighter. So I'm gonna start to space out my lines just ever so slightly. That was so slight you probably didn't even see it in the video. And I'm gonna do the same thing on this little handle here. It's kind of lighter on the inside and darker on the outside. So I can always go back, you know, and make it darker with either the gray marker or the black marker. You know, here it's light also here, so I'm just gonna put a little bit of turquoise. So on this lid, there is also some turquoise. So I'm gonna add, and I'm gonna do some lines here, but I'm gonna try to space them out to show that it's got a lot of light. And here it gets a little darker because it's kind of like the top of the lid, and on the edge it's a darker blue, so I'm gonna wait on that. So I have lighter turquoise here. It's a little lighter on the edge, so I'm just gonna do a few lines of the turquoise to give it that color, and then here is really dark, so I'm gonna color it in completely with the turquoise, but I did that, I messed up there, but I did that using just straight lines. Then here, as you get to the edge, it gets a little bit lighter, so I'm gonna space my lines out more, kind of like that. So you see some white or some gray that was left from the pencil. All right, moving down, I have this, the darkest part of the teapot is actually the middle part. So I'm gonna use this darker blue that I have, and I'm gonna end with this lighter blue. And if I need to go back and mix the blues and their turquoises together, to get kind of a middle tone, then I can definitely do that. So I'm in this middle part here, and I'm gonna, again, use lines, just hatching to kind of fill in that dark blue space. Here, at the bottom, it's got an even darker section of blue than the top part, so I'm gonna go, and again, I'm pretending like, okay, the teapot would be curving out, popping out towards me, so I'm gonna continue that pattern as I go over this part twice. This is just the darker part. If I need to darken it later, I can always, again, add the black or the gray. And then here, it's kind of like a lighter blue, so I am gonna use the blue, but I'm gonna try to space it out, and again, keeping the directions of my line kind of accurate to what's going on with the teapot. This one already colored, but I feel like it comes down a little bit more, so I'm gonna connect that a little bit. Maybe that wasn't accurate, but that's all right. Now, if I want to try to bring it together, I can add another line across both of them, so it increases the value together. So, get a little of that, some spot. And, all right, I'm at the last section here, so I'm gonna use this blue, and something that I forgot to do is go back on the lid and add kind of this darker blue detail. I know, I'm sure it's harder for you guys to see, but there is a band of blue kind of around like the top part of this lid. And again, looking at my object, I'm still looking at it even though I have spent this long drawing the same thing the whole time. All right, light blue. It's got a lot of shadow. It's got a lot of reflection going on here. So I'm going to start here, and I'm going to make this part, you know, the darkest part with a little bit of kind of space here, because that's what I'm seeing. Remember, it's, I did a lot of this work already with the black marker, so I'm not trying to overdo it with the color. I'm just trying to enhance what I had already done. So, all right, again, let's think about how this would function in space. It's going to pop out and curve because it's a teapot. So I'm going to spin my eyes, and I'm going to look at where I see all of these darks being reflected. It's pretty close to where I had already done the dark lines, but I just wanted to go there first. I'm even going up into this, that section above, to try to get it a little bit darker by going over it with the marker. So, all right, I'm kind of satisfied with that. I'm gonna continue my lines coming out. You know, this teapot is curvy, so it, so my lines are also gonna curve to reflect that a little bit. This Sharpie is kind of, it looks kind of dark blue with the cap, but when I actually put it on the paper, it's pretty light for a Sharpie, so I'm spending some time kind of going over this, creating like subtle values that I feel like kind of like go with the whole object. And I'm gonna add a little bit of light blue up here, because that's what I'm seeing. Now, what to do about this section here, the white section right below the lid of the teapot. I think I'm going to use my gray marker to kind of go in and enhance these different values of shadows that I'm seeing. So I see here it's got a shadow. I should have tested this before, but it looks like it's going to be fine. So the parts that I need a shadow on, I'm actually going to go over it with this gray, and that seems to do a pretty good job of making it more of an accurate shadow with the black and then the color, and now I'm adding some gray back on top. It's doing what I need it to do. Now keep in mind, you don't want to like go too much with it and then kind of, you know, lose all of the layers you put on, right? It's a push and a pull. It's adding to it so that you know, so it looks like what it is that you're looking at, but if you go too far with it, then it's just gonna kind of look like a blob and it's not gonna look like anything. So sometimes cross-hatching or doing lines in the opposite directions helps to inform the object. And I'm gonna do a little bit of that now, because this teapot's doing two things. It's coming around, like towards me, and it's also going around this way. So when you do that, you have lines that crisscross. So sometimes cross-hatching, even though it's a little, you know, not intuitive, it can really add some value, some information to the drawing that you're doing. And in this case, I feel like it's going to. So I'm adding a few lines across, but nothing like crazy. It's just to kind of give it the movement that the teapot's coming around this way, but it's also coming around this way. All right, the main part of me grabbing this gray marker was to add the value on this white part that I haven't touched yet. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna sit up tall, I should have been sitting up tall the whole time. I'm gonna add a little value gray on the bottom. Add a little value gray on top. I know it's really hard for you guys to see, but it has kind of like this white lip, like that the light is hitting the very end of this teapot. So I'm gonna just keep it like that. I don't wanna overdo it too much at this point. I tend to overdo this. Okay, I'm going to add a little bit of brown with this guy. Now, there are some shadows going on in the handle, this wooden handle part. So I'm actually gonna grab my black marker, and I'm gonna squint my eyes a little bit, and I'm gonna draw a little bit of the shadows that I'm seeing on the edge of this wooden. I'm not being concerned with the wooden spirals going on. I'm just kind of, I'm omitting that part of my vision to get more, just get a little bit of shadow, you know, here. So the shadow underneath, because the handle is curved, the shadow is here, kind of coming from the bottom. And then there's a little shadow here on the edge because the light is hitting this way, so everything over here is a little bit dark. Okay, let me turn it around so you guys can see. So yeah, even that shadow a little bit, it definitely added something to it. So I'm kind of hesitating with the brown because I know this brown is kind of dark. So I have this tan that perhaps, even though it's more of a peach, perhaps it would be a little bit better. I don't know. They're doing construction, so it's loud. My apologies. Okay, back to this handle. So I am essentially just going, now this is kind of a higher quality marker, so you can really build up the value a lot more. Again, you know, obviously it depends on what type of materials you're using. I think I'm just gonna start. I'm gonna go and I'm gonna add this peach on top of this black outline I just did. And actually the peach mixing with the black gives it kind of like a nice, almost brown color, so that was good. I, you know, that other, the brown marker wasn't too dark, I think. So I'm gonna just go like that. And the part of this handle that's darker is the bottom layer. So not the rectangles that are sitting on top, but the part that's underneath that. So I'm gonna actually manually go in and color like every other kind of band that I did. Again, I might not color it in completely. It's not a coloring book. I'm just doing a few line strokes to give it that like little bit of a darker contrast. You could say I'm kind of a lazy drawer. I'm not the most accurate drawer, but yeah. So that's the teapot that I drew. And here it is next to the actual teapot. So, when you look at these two things together, you can see that the actual teapot looks a little bit wider than, you know, what I drew. Something that I'm keeping in mind to make myself feel better is, you know, I was here drawing the teapot. So, you know, I have a little bit of a different angle. So ultimately, you know, you are the artist, and as long as you're proud of your drawing, that's really what matters. And, you know, the best thing that you can do is practice, draw something that you're passionate about, that you're going to be interested in drawing, because, you know, drawings can take several hours. So if you're going to be bored staring at the same thing, then I suggest choosing something that you're motivated to draw, you know, or that you find interesting. I love this teapot. I use it all the time. And, you know, it's not my best drawing ever, but, you know, that was just a quick tutorial to kind of review line, shape, value. And then in terms of the form and the color, you know, when you add line, shape, and value together, if you're doing it in a comprehensive way, it's going to start to make something look kind of three-dimensional, like it's popping off of the paper. I feel like I should fix this a little bit, actually. Maybe I will take my black marker and just kind of like pop this side out a little bit to make it a little bit. So I honestly, what all I did was I just thickened the edge on that side of the teapot, but you know, it kind of gives the illusion that what you did, you know, made the teapot wider, when really all I did was make the line longer. So anyways, to summarize, like I was saying, when you put line, shape, and value together successfully, you start to create forms, which a form is a 3D object, right? So you can think about drawing simple things like cubes and cones and things like that to practice. And then you can really translate that idea into drawing more complex figures, like the, you know, the teapot part is almost a sphere.
the spout part is almost like a cone, like a pyramid cone with the pointed edge. And yeah, and then when you put all those four things together, that's a good place to attempt to introduce color and using your line, your shape, your value, and your form to inform how to add the color on top. So it's not my most complex drawing, but I did end up liking it because I like this teapot a lot. So the last thing that you want to do is sign your artwork somewhere in the corner. And always good to date your artwork, because when you go back and look at it, you're going to be like, oh wow, I drew that a week ago, or oh wow, I drew that a year ago. And you may remember where you were at that time. So that's my final teapot drawing. Tune back in Tuesdays and Thursdays to do drawing tutorials or just get excited about art and just, you know, we'll make some art together on the Zoom, and it's been really fun. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this drawing lesson, and I hope to catch you guys next time. Bye.